substructor is a combinational logic circuit that performs the subtraction of three binary bits and produces two outputs. It is more advantageous as compared to half subtractor, which can perform only the subtraction of two binary bits.
Full subtractor is a combinational logic circuit which can subtract three binary bits A, B and a borrow bit and produces difference and borrow out or B out as an output. Now if we compare full subtractor with half subtractor, which can only perform the subtraction of two binary bit. Now full subtractor has the advantage over the half subtractor, where it can perform the subtraction of three binary bit. So we have three inputs A, B and B in, and two outputs D and B out. Now let's find out the truth table for difference and B out. We are going to find the values. So if we subtract 0 from 0, the result will be 0, and again if we subtract 0 from the 0, the result will be the 0 again. So in difference it is 0, in B out it is also 0. We are here performing the binary subtraction. We know the rule of binary subtraction. When 0 is getting subtracted from 0, the answer is 0. Whereas 1 is getting subtracted from 1, the answer is 0. When 0 is getting subtracted from 1, the answer is 1. And in case when 1 is getting subtracted from 0, the answer is difference is 1 and borrow out as 1. So here, next case, 0 minus 0, the answer is 0. And again, with the answer 0, we are subtracting 1. So 0 minus 1, that means in difference we have 1, and in borrow out we have also another 1. In this case, 0 minus 1 means we have 1 1 as a borrow out, so we are putting that 1, and we have another 1 in difference. So 1 minus 0, that means also 1. In next case, 0 minus 1, so we are getting 2 1s, so 1 1 for the borrow out, and we have remaining 1, that 1 is getting subtracted from this 1, so the result will be 0. In next case, here we are subtracting 0 from 1, so 1 minus 0 means the result is 1. Again 1 minus this 0, so the result is, the difference is 1, and we have borrow out as 0. In next case, first we subtract this 1 minus 0, the result is 1, and with that result we are going to subtract this 1, so 1 minus 1, the outcome is 0. In this case 1 minus 1, which is also 0, so with the result we are going to subtract the value that is in B in column, which is 0. So 0 minus 0, that means 0. And in the last case, 1 minus 1 means 0, and 0 minus 1 means we have 1 in the difference block and 1 in the borrow out block. So from this truth table we can construct the Boolean expression for both difference and borrow out. So first we are going to construct the Boolean expression for difference. So we are getting 4 1 for different possible combinations of A and B and B in. So starting from this one, we have got D equals to 1 when A equals to 0, B equals to 0 and B in equals to 1. So the equivalent mean term expression is A complement B complement B in. Next, we are getting D equals to 1 when A equals to 0, B equals to 1 and B in equals to 0. So the equivalent mean term expression is A complement B B in complement. For this one, we are getting D equals to 1 when A equals to 1 and B and B in both equals to 0. So the equivalent mean term expression is A B complement B in complement. And for the last one, we are getting D equals to 1 when all the three inputs are equals to 1. So that means A B B in. Now we can solve this Boolean expression. So let's reduce this Boolean expression with the laws of Boolean algebra. So we are just bringing the first term to last and rewriting this Boolean expression starting with the second term. Now from first to mean term we have got an expression like this. We are taking B in complement as common, and from this to mean term again we are getting B in as common. So the expression will be AB plus A complement into B in. Now we know that this is the logic expression of XOR gate. So instead of writing this, we can write A XOR B into B in complement, and this thing is XNOR gate. So we can also represent an XNOR gate in terms of XOR gate, and we also know that a XOR gate is the complement of XNOR gate, and obviously XNOR gate is the complement of XOR gate. So we can also write this expression in this way: the complement of XOR gate into B in. Now again this is the another part of XOR gate, so we can reduce this whole expression in terms of A XOR B XOR B in. So this is our reduced expression for difference. Now we have to find out the reduced expression for borrow also. So B out, we have got 4 times 1 in column B out. The first one is when A B both equals to 0 and B in equals to 1. So that means A complement B in. In the second case, when A and B in equals to 0 but B equals to 1, so that means A complement B in complement. In the third one, we have got 1 in column B out when A equals to 0 and both B and B in equals to 1, so it means A complement B B in. And in the last case, all three values equals to 1, so that is A B B in. So we can arrange this equation. So again we are bringing the first term to last. So what we have got: A complement B B in complement plus B in plus A B B in plus A complement B in. Now we can take A complement B the term as common, so we left only B in complement plus B in, and here we have A B plus A complement and we are taking B in as common. So from the law of Boolean expression we know that B in plus B in complement, which is also equivalent to 1. So therefore this thing can also be written as A complement B dot 1 plus this is, we can reduce this expression, this is the symbol or the logical expression of XNOR gate, which is can also be expressed in terms of XOR gate. So that means A XOR B whole complement into बी इन. सो दिस इज आवर एक्सप्रेशन ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट बी प्लस ए जॉर बी होल कॉम्प्लीमेंट इन टू बी इन. सो वी हैव फाइंड आउट द बुलियन एक्सप्रेशन फॉर डिफरेंस वेयर डी इक्वल्स टू ए जॉर बी जॉर बी इन एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो फाइंड आउट द बुलियन एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ बी आउट वेयर बी आउट इक्वल्स टू ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट बी प्लस ए जॉर बी कॉम्प्लीमेंट इन टू बी इन. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू ड्रॉ द लॉजिक सर्किट ऑफ फुल सबट्रैक्टर. Now in the circuit diagram of half full subtractor, for finding the difference, in the difference equation we have two XOR gate. So this thing is A XOR B, and this one is equivalent to D, which is A XOR B XOR B in. So now we have to obtain only the B out. So in the B out term, first we have A complement B, so we are taking connection from A, making the complement. For complement we will use the NOT gate, and one from B, so that makes us A complement B, and we have A or B complement into B in. So also we are taking connection from this, we are making complement, so that makes us A or B whole complement, and one connection from B in, which is also fit AND gate. So this is A or B complement into B in. Now we have to only include an OR gate. So this is the first one, A complement B, and this is the second one. Just we have to include an OR gate. So this is B out exactly, which is equals to A complement B plus A XOR B whole complement into B in. So this is the logic circuit for full subtractor. Now if we carefully watch this logic circuit, we can see one thing, that compare this with half subtractor. In half subtractor we have one XOR gate, one AND gate, and one NOT gate. So this part of the circuit works similar as that of half subtractor. And again this part of the circuit, one XOR gate, one NOT gate, and one AND gate also work as half subtractor. So full subtractor is nothing but full subtractor, we can say from this diagram, that is a combination of two half subtractor.
Thanks for watching the video. If you like the video, then hit the like button, subscribe to this channel, and share the video with others, and hit the notification bell icon for regular updates.